Breathing is something that we take for granted and you never think about until you lose the ability to breathe. Now, following an injury, this is devastating to the individual that has to live with this condition. And so what we're targeting is improved ability for the brain and the spinal cord to activate the respiratory muscles. So our therapies, we're using a drug approach or oxygen-based approach, are all intended to help improve the ability of these connections to restore independent breathing to individuals with spinal injury. As you can imagine, if you're living with a severe spinal cord injury, there's many, many challenges. We've been talking about breathing. When you can't breathe independently, that is severely limits your quality of life, your ability to interact with your environment, your ability to interact with friends and families, ability to leave your room. This is all impaired when you can't breathe independently. So this is a major challenge we're trying to solve. So what we're doing is trying to fix two aspects of that injury. The first is that once there's been an injury to the spinal cord, the connections between the brain and the cord get interrupted. And so we're developing pharmacologic strategies to make those connections work better. These are called synapses, and so we use a drug which we think can improve how these synapses function. The second thing that we're doing is trying to manipulate oxygen levels in order to promote recovery. So when the spinal cord's been damaged, the amount of oxygen that's delivered to the spinal cord gets very, very low. In fact, it can reach zero. This very low oxygen impairs function and can lead to loss of cells in the spinal cord. So we've been testing strategies to raise the amount of oxygen delivered to the cord in an effort to preserve tissue and prevent that loss and damage. There is a clear path towards translating this basic science research into clinical practice. Because we're doing relatively simple things, we're just manipulating the amount of inspired oxygen, which is something that is medically relatively easy to do. And so if this proves to be successful, I think it can very rapidly help the individuals with spinal cord injury. Similar with the drugs that we're exploring, we're using drugs that have already been used for other purposes in humans. So the ability to get approval and translate that to clinical testing, we think, is going to be relatively straightforward. There's really many reasons, I think, that inspire me to do this work. The most significant one is the hope that we can alleviate some of the difficulty that individuals with spinal cord injury are facing. I have the opportunity to work with just wonderful people. I have a terrific team in the lab. I get to bring in undergraduate students and teach them about science, PhD students, and help them on their journey towards becoming scientists. And we have a wonderful team of postdoctoral fellows in the lab who I can mentor and help them as they learn how to be independent researchers. As we go forward, I'm very excited to take what we've learned with our laboratory science and see if we can bring that into the clinic and help individuals.